Hello, this is the Silver Watchman here to join you on another episode of Random Heroes. Now, this should be episode number 7. Now, in the last episode, we talked about faith. My gosh, every single one of my videos are heavy. Well then, now keep in mind, I'm going to continue on off probably on the same vein as we did last time. Faith is not the easiest thing to have. Especially if you have some impossible odds that you have to face. I mean, nobody really wakes up saying, "Hey, I'm gonna go challenge the entire world." Unless you're one of those people, in which case you're probably super, super arrogant. Because a lot of what walking with God requires is faith. Now, as I just said, it's not the easiest thing to have, because sometimes God expects you to trust in Him in a situation where it can be very, very terrifying for you. God might give you authority that you honestly are kind of scared to have. That you're scared to take that next step, because you're scared of what that could mean. Faith. If you're gonna walk with God, faith is not optional. It's pretty mandatory, or else you're going to end up walking away from God. Because it's just too scary. And yes, walking with God can be kind of scary, but know this. What you're facing up against to you may seem like a giant, insurmountable thing that you have to come to get over. But to God, it's more like a walk in the park. A bit of a breeze. And if you think about it, that just makes what you're about to face up against a little less scary. To know that, yeah, for you, it's kind of a big problem. But to God, it's just like, Don't worry, I've got your back. And yeah, it's... Every man of God has his moment where... he struggles with faith. Because every man, you know, appointed a certain amount of faith to have. Now for some men, a big struggle of faith is whether or not to go and buy that new car because you need it for work, but you don't make enough to pay for it. Now, I'm not going to downcast what you, but that, if that's an issue for you, I'm not going to downcast that. For other men, a big struggle of faith is you're about to go into surgery and you don't know if you're going to come out of that surgery. So, everybody has a different type of struggle. Or for somebody else, it's your kid is sick with a disease that they don't know what it is. And you don't know whether or not they're going to be here tomorrow. So you're just praying to God to have a little bit more time. Now, in a lot of cases, that prayer isn't really answered. Well, it's not answered in the way that you want. Because then they go. But everybody here has a set amount of time. It doesn't matter how old you get. You know, all that working out to keep your body young and fit. Yeah, no, that's just a waste of time. Because if God says it's your time to go, then it's your time to go. Now, alternatively, there are things that you can do to give yourself a little bit more time. One is coming to serve God. So long as you don't, you know, even if you're adamant in rejecting God, and I'm not even going to repeat the phrase because that is dangerous to repeat. But those of you that do not know God, you know it well. Those of you that do know God have forgotten it. And that's good if you've forgotten that phrase. And I know that sometimes God can, you know, bring forth something so unbelievable that it just, for some people, it's spooky. And you just want to get away because it's just too much. But know this. It is better to stick it out, no matter how afraid you get. Because yes, even I have those moments where I am struggling with faith. Even God had his own moment, believe it or not. God himself had a moment when he was walking among us as a human. Where he was struggling with what he had to do, which was basically let himself get beaten to death by his own creation, defy death by coming back to life. But before that, before coming back to life, he had to go straight down into hell, pull all of those people out of paradise, which is what the Catholics believe is purgatory. Now, here's the thing. Paradise is no longer around. Right now, it is known as Paradise Fallen because it is now part of the rest of the hell. So purgatory doesn't exist. If you guys really want to believe that there's a purgatory in between heaven and hell, I guess the closest thing you've got now would have to be Earth. Yeah. Because purgatory is described as, my memory is correct, as this thing that where souls go to repent of their sins, and when they're done repenting, then they get to go to heaven. Which is why a lot of the fear of God is gone. Because people believe, oh, I'll just end up in purgatory, I'll just do whatever and it'll get. People don't actively try to walk with God anymore. They just accept that they're saved and then that's it. And even I'm guilty of this. But then God called me. And I saw how much you really have to work to stay in the Lord. And yeah, I know it can be kind of scary. But it's worth the effort. It's worth every single effort, every single teardrop, every single bead of sweat. Because apart from God, you've got no shot at being in heaven. Your final destination will be hell. But God is merciful. It's not like you won't be able to go to ask for forgiveness and then God will just, you know, kind of brush you off. No. If you ask for forgiveness and you mean it in your heart, in your soul, and your mind, he'll hear you. Now, will you still suffer the consequences of your sin? At times, yes. Because sometimes you just gotta learn. And, you know, there are people out there that are kind of like me. Very, very stubborn people. Now, we don't mean to be stubborn, we just kind of are. So when God asks us to do something that we cannot believe is... or it just defies our personalized little, you know, idea of what's going on, what we believe is the right way that things should go. And then when God does something that contradicts our belief, Then we want to shrug him off, like saying, oh, he's not good, or the people of him are not good, because... you know, we basically said something that you didn't like. But here's the thing. God looks at your heart. So you want to be judgmental? Fine. You can do that on your own terms. And yeah, I'm not saying that everything that is of God is easy to palatize, easy to do, easy to look at, easy to, you know. But what I am saying is that it's worth it. Because ever since I got saved, yeah, my life, I would say, maybe may have gotten a bit harder. But for the first time in my life, I don't feel empty. For the first time in my life, I feel like I matter. And when you're down, God will encourage you. When you're sad, God knows how to comfort you so you don't, you know, so that sadness is not all that consumes you. So in the end, it's better. It's better. Your life will be so much better. Keep in mind, though, hypocrites receive their due punishment. Those that serve God with an arrogant heart are very quickly humbled. And trust me, I can attest to that. It's better for you to check yourself than to have God check you. Because when that happens, It's like, you know, when you were younger and you got a spanking. It really makes you go like, oh. And for some people, that's too much for them. And it makes them feel like, oh, I come to serve God and this is how he treats me. I might as well just walk away. No, here's the thing. Biblically speaking, in God's eyes, if you're willing to discipline your own kid, then guess what? That means that you love your kid and you want the best for your kid. Now, is every human very good at discipline? No, I am not good at discipline either. I'm one of those people that just act stubborn. I don't mean to be stubborn, it's just how I am. But before you go off and getting ready to judge me, know this. Even though I can be pretty stubborn sometimes, I'm also somebody that will stick their neck out for you multiple times, even when there's no benefit in it. Now, I try not to shove God down anybody's throats. I say try because I don't do that very well. I mess up. But everybody messes up. Now, on this channel, we're not always going to say everything that, you know, everything that you like. Sometimes we're gonna say something and it's going to make you mad. Because it contradicts what you have, what you believe. But here's the thing though. I am doing this with the full help from God. Which means every time I get discouraged, God encourages me. And it's always like randomly too. It's always like when, like, I'm just trying to avoid everybody and I'm just kind of holding it in, all of my fear, all of my doubt. And God will just randomly send somebody to just be like, hey, you're gonna be all right. Or something along the lines of that, and it touches my heart. And sometimes it's something that I need so much. But when that encouragement comes, I just break down. Which honestly surprised the person, because I'm not the kind of person that just cries. That's just not me. But that's what I'm talking about when you come to serve God and you trust Him. When you need Him the most, He'll be there. He's always waiting for you to make that phone call to Him. Now, I know I've spoken in other videos why I have the authority to, when I meet somebody, to either say, this person is good for the kingdom of heaven, please keep him around a little longer, just a little longer. Get him saved. Or, their heart is too hard. Remove them from this world. They will not come to you no matter what. Now that is not a decision that is made easily, and it never will be. More often than not, I'm pleading to God to just keep me here a little longer. No, to those of you that don't know God, that sounds scary. To those of you that do know God and you have the wrong impression of who God is, that's even scarier. But know this, this authority is not given lightly. It's given to somebody who honestly does care. And will weep if somebody dies and they're not saved. And that's something I actually do. Somebody dies and they're not saved, and I'm aware that they're not saved, I cry because I know where they're going. But to everybody that comes to serve God, you're going to be given your own level of, like, authority over different matters, depending on what your heart is, you know? Is somebody that's extremely judgmental and believes that they're right all the time, that person is not going to have the same authority I have. I'm a person that, honestly, I second-guess myself at every single turn. That feeling of knowing that somebody's got your back no matter what, it's the best feeling in the world. Because even if all of your friends abandon you, then God won't. Even if, you know, the world is falling apart around you, God won't fall. And some people, when they see a Christian that's in, you know, with their own trial, every Christian goes through trials and struggles of faith. Even I go through my struggles, as I've already said. But it's a point that needs to be made. Walking with God is not the easiest thing in the world, and it never will be the easiest thing in the world, because you're basically, you know, going against everything that you've been taught to believe. Because, you know, racial stigmas, or, you know, with people that are judgmental, or what somebody believes. Now when you're a really judgmental person and you're judging other people, they're not going to want to be around you. Even I don't want to be around somebody that's super judgmental. Because you're judging thinking that you have the high ground. You have no high ground. There's no such thing as the high ground when you're human. Because you're just as flawed as everybody else. And there was a time when you needed to be saved too. Now, if you're walking with God and you haven't reached that like moment where you're struggling with faith, ask yourself, what are you actually doing for God? Because if you haven't hit that moment yet, you're either very, very brand new and being saved, or you're not doing enough for God. Because we're supposed to be challenged. We're not supposed to be like, you know, we're supposed to be content, but not exactly what one would say is comfortable. Comforted. Yes. But you should feel like walking with God is, you should always feel like there's always something more. You should never say in your own heart that I have done enough. Because in the end, it's never going to be enough. And I will admit, I'm guilty of that too. Saying, oh, I have done enough. There's nothing more I can do. Let me just shove them off. Shove this situation off to somebody else. They'll handle it. Here's the thing, if God brings you a situation, it's probably because He wants you to handle it. Now, you can ask for advice and you can ask for help. But if God gives you a responsibility, He wants you to, you know, to take responsibility. Now, that sometimes requires for you to take that leap, that really big, really scary leap. Now, the first time I was talking about faith, I was honestly shaking because I was going through a struggle. And even now, I'm kind of struggling even a little bit more. But it's not as bad as it was. I was scared because God was asking me to do something that I had never done before. This required more faith than I had ever needed in my entire life. For most people, you know, a big struggle of faith is going to talk to somebody else about God. Or admitting that you're not perfect. Or I don't know. But for me indeed, it was being tasked with being in charge of a lot of people. And then here I am, I'm still coming to terms with the fact that, oh right, I'm saved and God wants me to be the silver watchman. Then God's like, also, a lot of lives are resting on your shoulders too. And it honestly took months for me to come to terms with that. And even now I'm still kind of coming to terms with that because it's like I had to do something that I haven't done since I got saved. I had to fast about it. I had to fast about it, and I spoke to God, and His answers, it scared me. It scared me, and I wept. I wept because I was afraid. But it's been a while, a little bit. Even though I'm still coming to terms with what God has told me, I'm comforted by the fact that even when I was, you know, first coming to terms with it, that God throughout that entire time was comforting me. Telling me that it's gonna be alright. That He's got me. And just like how He did that for me, He'll do that for you too. Think about that. Wouldn't you rather, you know, when you're really sad or you're really scared, know that an all-powerful, all-knowing being has got your back no matter what? Know that even with the fear, you know, it feels like it's overwhelming. God will help you to be courageous when the time came to. That you don't have to run away. So long as you trust God. It's a lot scarier to walk alone than it is to walk knowing that an all-powerful being has got your back. That it wasn't a mistake that you got saved. It's not a mistake that you're hearing how you matter. A lot of people would rather have that mentality of, oh, look, I'm not special. You wouldn't exist if you weren't special. But you do. So you are. You could have died in the womb. You could have died on a drive to work. You could have died while you were a kid. At any given point, you could have died. Even from something as benign as eating a piece of candy, you could have died. But you're not. And you didn't. And you're alive. And you're listening to this. God's got a plan for you. And I know that plan may be kind of scary for some people. But for others, it's not. For others, it's something as simple as going to take care of children. Or for people like me, it's for somebody that doesn't like to be in the limelight. You know, like to be the focus of everybody, would just much rather, you know, go in, have a few group of friends and just, you know, just talk about whatever, like food and stuff. Suddenly, having to walk amongst crowds of people and just be like that. I'm still trying to find words for it because it's still kind of scary for me. I'm comforted now that I took the time to talk to God and ask Him. Then when I was flopping around like a fish, you know, trying to figure out whether or not this is really what God chose me to do, because now I know it's what God chose me to do. And it's not just being the Silver Watchman on YouTube, it's other things that I can't say right now. But thanks to that knowledge, a whole bunch of things that never made sense before in my entire life now make sense. None of my struggles were for nothing. None of yours are for nothing either. At the end of the day, every single struggle just adds to your testimony, which you will tell in faith to God, to other people, so they can come to know God too. And that's just beautiful. That even somebody as insignificant as me can be plucked from the crowd to do something amazing for God. Which means you could do something amazing too. Be able to do something amazing. you who ought to sit there and be depressed because all you've ever done in your whole life is just mess up and make mistakes, and that's why you were so scared in the first place. Because you're scared that you're just going to mess up and you're going to fail God. And then you ask God, and God tells you, you're not going to mess up because you have me. Now, if they don't like it, they could go and talk to me about it. They can ask me, and I will tell them, this is what I've chosen you to do. For those of you that need that level of comfort, that'll comfort you so much that you'll just up and cry. Because those were the exact words that you needed to hear for years. Because unlike normal, you know, God won't be ashamed of you unless you're ashamed of Him. And I'm not ashamed of God. But I do have to overcome my... As it currently stands with this video, I am scared of people. I don't like arguing or getting into conflicts. So when God tells me to do something, well, I'm going to be pretty much the focus of a lot of people, and they're going to, you know, yell at me and think mean things about me, which I could feel their thoughts. And it scared me. And I wept because I was afraid. But then God comforted me and said, even if they hated you, even if they hate you right now, they hated me first. Or else they wouldn't blaspheme me. They wouldn't try so hard to get rid of me. And I've got your back. And I wept. I don't know how many times I've said that in this video alone, but you just gotta take that leap of faith. For you that are not saved and you're waiting for some kind of really big, super miraculous sign so you can come to know God, I mean, I'm not gonna say you're not gonna get it. But it would be better to come to God without receiving that sign. Because in the comfort of coming to know God, it's all the more amazing. Just awesome. Now, I don't know what the future would hold for you. I don't know the future. But I do know the will of God, at least in part, because I am not the best at understanding what God wants. You and I make bad calls. But know this, serving God is, it's a lot more than just, you know, bowing down to pray. It's all about taking that big step, that big scary step, in the name of the Lord. Taking that big jump. Defying everybody and what everybody else believes is to be impossible. To acknowledge what God says is possible. And if you're saying to yourself, oh, it's impossible for me to get saved, why would God ever want somebody like me? Keep in mind, I was about as far away from God as one could get. Full of wrath and vileness and evil. And God took one look at me and said, I'm gonna make you into a man of me. And you know what? He did. So God wants you to be a person of Him. He chose you. He chose you to be this. I don't know what He chose you for, but I just know it's going to be amazing. Because you're living, you're breathing. Because God says for you to keep on living. Because He wants you to come to Him. He wants you to do this purpose that I don't know what it is, but I just know it's going to be awesome and amazing. And if you've watched pretty much all of my videos, thank you. It's an honor to be doing this, to be the Silver Watchman. To be chosen by God. Even though I myself view myself as the most unworthy being on the face of the earth. The glory be to God. Thank you for watching. Thank you for sitting through all these videos. And thank you for trying to keep at least non-judgmental heart as much as you can. Blessings be upon you. Glory be to God, and this is the Silver Watchman, signing out.